In this video, I will talk about the current sector rotation in the S&P 500 index. And of course, at the end of this video, I will also give a market outlook. So stay tuned up to the end and let's start. The content for today's video is the current market situation, of course, the inloopo stock market indicator, the interest rates from the US, the current business cycle, determined by the US leading economic index. And of course, one of the main things is the current sector rotation, first of all, in theory, and then the reality check. My inloopo stock market indicator is published every Sunday on my website, inloopo.com. I'm here on my website. And of course, you can also join my free Telegram channel. There you can ask questions and you can you get everything in real time on your smartphone. So basically what it says, the stock market indicator is red. And this is the case since 3 weeks. You can see the full history. I think I started this last year, somewhere in May. In the Telegram channel, you can scroll back all the messages. It's only one message every weekend, the inloopo stock market indicator. And well, of course, this indicator is based here on several other sub-indicators, COT data, S&P 500 above or below moving average, trend, momentum, divergence, and the spread of the VIX futures. So currently, the inloopo stock market indicator is red. Markets are going down. But what does this have to do with the overall picture? The overall picture, of course, is also in relation to the Fed interest rates. And you can check the Fed interest rates on the CME Fed Watch tool here on this page. You can see there in 30 days, there is the next Fed interest rates decision. And you can also see here on the probabilities, you can see an outlook what traders and investors do expect for the upcoming months. And here you can see that everybody is expecting that the interest rates may stay the same up until March of 24. A couple of months ago, traders and investors expected that interest rates should decrease by end of this year. Then they jumped to January next year, and now they are already expecting steady interest rates up until March of next year. So this is pretty interesting. And this has an effect on the markets. And if this, for example, stays the same and the Fed will not decrease interest rates, maybe they will increase the interest rates again, then of course this has more impact to the markets than any other thing what we discuss in today's video. So this is very crucial. And of course, the Fed said in all the meetings from the last months that it will do its decisions based on data. They will analyze the data and based on the data, they will do the decisions. So from my point of view, they will watch the market carefully. They will watch the data carefully, the fundamentals. And if something is not in line with their expectation, then they will, of course, stop raising, staying the same, or they will even decrease earlier with their interest rates. So this is my expectation. I think the Fed does not want to move the markets to the downside. They want to have a healthy US economy, especially in this crazy times with the overall world, I would say, power movements, shifts to Asia or not. We will see this within the upcoming years. Next, what is also very important is the current business cycle. And the current business cycle, you can see here on my website, again, Economiy Cycle. I analyzed the economic cycle with the leading indicators from the conference board, US conference board, and I calculate this here on year over year basis and update this every month at the end of each month here on my website. So the current business cycle is up to date. I updated this 2 days ago And it still says that we are in a recovery phase because the US leading indicator found a bottom here and points to the upside. And of course now in the last down moves, this worked very well. And we went out of the recession without any drop again. Only here you can see this in 20 and 2000 recession, we had an up and down and up and down, and the US leading indicator did not work that well to determine the real bottom of the markets. So if we are not having the similar situation than in 2000-2001, then we should stay in the recovery phase, and from the recovery phase we go back to the early growth phase. And this is what you can see here. This is the sector rotation model. So we come from recovery to early growth, late growth, rebound and decline. And of course, each sector rotation phase has its preferred sectors, which should outperform the market. So currently in recovery phase, we should have materials, consumption, cyclical and communication to outperform the market. So this is based on theory. I checked all this and developed all this tool since 1999, and it worked very, very accurately. So we had, I think it was 20 business cycles in total since then, and only in 5 business cycles this model did not outperform the S&P 500. It was slightly less performance, but in the other 15 business cycles, it definitely and clearly outperformed the S&P 500. So this is what we want to do. And now we're going to check if this is true for the current business cycle or not. So let's go to Trading View, and here you can see my Trading View chart. I have the S&P 500 index in black line, and I have this 10 sector ETFs here in the different colors. And one main thing, what is very, very unique, like every recession has its strong and weak sectors, because of course every recession has some whatever technology bubble, financial crisis, and so on. And let's check how the markets behaved this time and which were the weakest sectors since this high point here in January 22. Because this is one main thing about strength and weakness comparison. If you compare like the sectors, if you want to see which one is the strongest, do this always from the high and the low points of each underlying. So here in red, you can see the high point from S&P 500, 3rd of January 22. And then with the blue lines, you can see the shift from one business cycle to the next one. And let's zoom in again and move it to the red line. Well, it does not matter that much if it's very, very precise, just to give you a big overview where we are. So here you can see that since January 22, energy definitely outperformed the market. Well, we know all this, but very interesting is that it is still very, very high and close to the all-time high, especially the last month. Also, energy stocks went to the upside. But this is not the focus for the sector rotation currently. We want to focus on were the weakest sectors since this high point. And if we take a look at the overall picture, then we see here communication, XLC, and consumer cyclical, XLY, are the weakest, still the weakest sectors, and they have also been the weakest sectors here at the low point of S&P 500. And this is very important and very interesting. So then it is the financials, but the financials, they were pretty much in line with S&P 500, outperformed the markets, the S&P 500 a bit here in November 22, then February 23. And of course, then we had the banking crisis in the US, and then financial stocks dropped a bit below S&P 500 performance. But this picture does totally look different than, for example, 2000 recession or financial crisis 2008. Take a look and go back and prove it to yourself. So this all looks totally different. So what about the sector rotation now? So from my point of view, this is very important, because the main issues since February 22 were not in the financials, were not in technology crisis. It was just like communication stocks and consumer cyclicals who went to the downside, and this totally, well, fit to the overall market expectation. So there is, from my point of view, if consumer cyclicals will recover, then this is one of the main signs that we are not getting into a very, very strong recession within the next years. I would say this year and maybe beginning of next year, we will not get a strong recession. And let's prove this and let's analyze this. So here you can see always the moves from one sector rotation or economic phase to the next one. And let's just jump to the current market phase and analyze the sector rotation. So here you can see the current economic cycle. Since May, we have this recovery phase. And within this recovery phase, the strongest sectors were consumer cyclical, technology, and communication. So this is very important. You have to put this into the overall context. Since February 22, no, since the beginning of the recession, we had communication and consumer cyclical were the weakest sectors. And now, since the beginning of this recovery, they really recover. They are the strongest, and they definitely clearly outperform the market. And then we have industries still outperforming the S&P 500, and energies, of course, outperforming the S&P 500, just slightly, but still this is 0.7%. Then on the downside, below S&P 500, we have financials, we have materials, we have health and consumer non-cyclicals, and utilities. So, and this is also, we have to have always in our head, if we are getting into a very, very strong recession, then according to the model, the consumption non-cyclical sector or utilities should stay like pretty flat and well, outperform the S&P 500, not get into that strong drawdown than all the other sectors. So currently, it doesn't look like we are heading into a recession, because the sectors which were weak within the last 1.5 years definitely clearly recovered. And well, now, of course, we are getting into an interesting phase, because since about 31st of July, so since about more than 1.5 months, we are having here, I would say, a correction in the S&P 500 and of course in all the other markets. And this is now interesting because now we can check also who is the strongest and the weakest sector within this last 1.5 months. And we can see that energies, health, and then consumption, non-cyclical industries and financials, they are outperforming the market. Well, the energies, I would say this is still related to the war between Ukraine and Russia. So still we have this war ongoing. So there is a special situation for the energy stocks. This does not fit into any kind of sector rotation model. This is due to political effects. But we can see that health non-cyclical consumption stocks, they were the strongest within this correction, of course. And now we need to analyze for the upcoming months if this will stay the same. If this will be the case, that non-cyclical consumption stocks will outperform the S&P 500 within the next move to the upside, then this is definitely a strong sign that we might head into a recession recovery and the bear market is not over yet. So this is a very interesting scenario, what we are having in the next weeks, I would say. This is how I also analyze if the sector rotation model is right or wrong. And this is always what we have to take into account. This kind of fixed models, they can be right and they are right in most of the cases, but of course they can also be wrong, or like economic phases can be shifted for a couple of months or sometimes even years. What we can also see here, this correction, the weakest sectors are technology, of course, consumer cyclical and materials and communication. So the markets or the sectors which outperformed the S&P 500 since this recovery phase, they are also, of course, like giving away their profits in relationship to the S&P 500 in this correction. And this is definitely something what we have to watch. Coming back to this model and this current business phase, and what also is pretty important is that when we take a look at this sector rotation, it definitely fits to the sector rotation model. So two out of the three, consumer cyclical and communication, are definitely outperforming the market. Only the materials, they are not outperforming the market. And this is like typical for, I would say, the sector rotation model. They are always or mostly, like if there are three sectors within one phase, then mostly two of them are outperforming the market and one is not. It's not always the same, but this is why the sector rotation model works quite robust. And of course, now at this point of time, it's the materials. This does not mean that this model does not work. It works, but only one is not following this model, and this is a total normal situation. But what is also interesting is what comes next. If we are heading to early growth, and this is the case when the economic cycle, the leading economic index, crosses this -3 line, which might be at the end of this year, probably, then we are heading into the early growth. And in early growth, energy, finance, and industry should outperform the market. And this is also what we can see currently, because industry and energy already outperform the market. Finance, well, still having some problems, but if the Fed will not increase interest rates further on, if they maintain the interest rates or even lower the interest rates earlier than the Fed Watch tool said, then the financials will recover and they will then profit from these political decisions. So at the end of this video, I want to give you a quick summary and market overview. So the current market situation, of course, in the short and mid-term, the inloopo stock market indicator is red. So I think for the next weeks, we will have the continuation of this correction, what we are currently in, maybe up until beginning of October, in line with the seasonality, we will see all this. The interest rates are definitely one of the key drivers of the upcoming markets. And this is something good, because the Fed does not want to have a very, very deep recession. It wants to maintain balanced. Usually, it does not want to create bubbles, and it wants to have like a slow and steady growth for the US economy. So it does not want to fight the US economy. And this is also in relationship to the current business cycle. The current business cycle is in recovery phase. Maybe end of 23, we are changing to early growth phase. If the US leading economic indicator will move above -3 level. We talked about the current sector rotation since May, and since May, in theory, communication, consumer cyclical and materials should outperform the S&P 500. This is not the case for this phase, because in reality, in this phase, there are even more sectors which outperform the market. Materials is not one of these sectors, but very interesting, it is already industries and energies, the sectors from the early growth phase, which are already outperforming the market at the current state. And all this, from my point of view, currently from the current status, is leading that we are in a bull market. We are not in a bear market anymore. The bear market is over. And I think if the Fed will make a proper job, and if we see this also here in the next sectors, especially the financials, if the financials will not drop heavily, we will head into a bull market and probably into a very strong end of the year rally, starting maybe mid of October this year. So that's it for this quick overview. Thanks for watching. If you like this content, give me a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, or leave a comment below. As always, I wish you successful investing. Always manage your risk. This is the most important thing, and stay tuned. Bye-bye.